Day four, and I'm at quite the sight right now. This here is the junction between the New York Long Path and the Appalachian Trail. This is the spot 2 years ago, almost to this very date, I learned of the existence of the New York Long Path. And at that point, when I saw that it went 291 miles north of here and 60 miles south of here, I was like, take out my list, New York Long Path. AT, check. That way, you get to Maine. That way, you get to Georgia. That way, you get back to New York City. And that way, you go all the way up through to northern New York, in Altamont, just outside of Albany. 291 miles left to go. Rather historic place for me right here. Morning of day five. Spent the night last night at Stockbridge Shelter. Nice looking little shelter. The boards are a little old and messed up, but what are you gonna do? Harriman and Bear Mountain State Parks here are absolutely beautiful. Some amazingly stunning scenery. Incredibly scenic area. The only problem that I can find with it is that the shelters, one, are not pretty well maintained, and two, they were not placed where it is convenient to get water for the most part, which is unfortunate if you're a thru-hiker like me, where you need to have easy access to water. So I had to fill up my platypus yesterday, 2 miles before the shelter, or so, and carry that 2 liters of water that I did not want to carry the last 2 miles uphill of my hike. Now for somebody out west where it's really dry, you go, oh, 2 miles, wah, I have to carry 2 gallons of water, 10 miles, you know, stuff like that. And you're right, but out here in the Northeast, if you're an ultralight or minimalist backpacker like myself, you don't want to have to carry that water. You want to keep your pack as close to under 20 pounds as possible. If you got 2 liters or 4 or 5 pounds of water on your back, that's going to weigh you down. It's going to decrease your range for the day. But I suppose there's not much we can do about it. The shelters are placed the way they're placed. So it was an 11 mile or so day yesterday from one shelter to another, and that's the last shelter I'm going to see for a long time. So the first challenge of this trail was to find lodging for the first 40 miles of the trail before the first shelter, and now the challenge was to find shelter, or lodging rather, for the next 45, 50 miles of the trail where there's no shelters, there's no campsites, nothing. But I have a plan. Standing on a railroad bridge, and besides the really cool feature right here, the reason I'm filming here is because for the next mile and a half, I'll be hiking up the largest geological feature thus far on the Long Path. It's Schunemunk Mountain. Now in the next mile and a half, I'm going to raise over 1,000 feet in elevation.
which is more by about 200 to 300 feet than you have, than I have done, or you would do, for the entire trail up until this point. Schunemunk Mountain is a really, really cool looking mountain. You go up 1,000, 1,200 feet, and then it levels off for probably 4 or 5 miles, and it's ridge walking by the look of it. So it's just a trail profile. However, remember this quote, trail profiles lie. Gonna go up for 1.5 miles, over for 5 miles, and then down for 1.5 miles. This should be fun. I'm at the peak, one of the peaks of Schunemunk Mountain right now. I believe this is called High Knob. You have got to see this view. This is a gorgeous place in this. Ooh. The hike up wasn't that bad. It was very gradual. And now that I'm on sort of a table right now, it looks like it's going to be gradual from here to the end. Which I'm happy for. Now, it was very gradual up until the last, ooh, maybe 200 feet of vertical, where it got pretty steep, but that's not bad, considering that it could have been steep the whole way. And it was very manageable. It's just a good trail. Well-maintained. And as you could see, the view is spectacular. First view of the Schunemunk Ridge and the Catskill Mountains. I'm getting there. Setting up camp here. Got my tent behind me. First time I've had to use it, and it's the end of day 5, so I'm pretty happy about that. I'm at Hil-Mar Lodge after a 20-mile day. It really wasn't that bad of a day. Starting out was a little tough, going up over some really steep, though not very tall, mountains. But once you hit the roads, it's smooth sailing. Schunemunk Mountain is not that bad. You go up, you go across, and you go down. There's a couple little steep spots that are not in the trail profile. Again, trail profiles lie, that you have to deal with, but other than that, it's pretty much just smooth sailing all the way. Now, Hil-Mar Lodge, they let hikers stay right over here, and I didn't know that coming into this, but I called ahead anyway because I saw on using Google Earth that this place existed and it was right on the trail. So I called them up and asked if I could stay here during my hike, and they said, yeah, absolutely. And here I am, talking to one of the gentlemen that owns the place. His name's Anton. Fantastic, fantastic guy. If you come here and he's here, talk to this guy. He is just wonderful, knowledgeable about the history of the area, and his family's been here since the 20s. So definitely a good person to converse with.